Hi and a good day to all of you. How many of you actually want to see your names in FIRs? Obviously, the answer to that question is nobody wants to see their own names in an FIR. The second question I want to ask you is, how many of you want yourself to be pleaded or arrayed as a defendant in a lawsuit? Clearly, the answer for that is also obvious. Nobody wants to be a defendant or to be embroiled in any litigation or lawsuit. But the fact of the matter is that if you are the CSO, then you have to realize that these are now going to be increasingly important risks that you will have to take it into your consideration and in your stride as you go along. The reason is very clear, because the law of the land has changed dramatically and steadily over the last 13 and a half years. Today, when we are talking about security, it's not just physical security, it's information security, it's cyber security. And all of you gentlemen are dealing with primarily seven raw materials that constitute the digital and the mobile ecosystems. Whenever you are doing your day-to-day activities or you're managing the securities of your respective organizations, you are concerned with the use of computers, computer systems, computer networks, computer resources, communication devices, as also data and information in the electronic form. This is all that you deal with, right? And this is all that's a subject matter of a special legislation, being the Indian Cyber Law. This is the Information Technology Act 2000, as amended by the Information Technology Amendment Act 2008. Now, the first question that you are going to ask you is, I'm a CSO, why should I be bothered about cyber law? And what should it impact me in any case? Primarily because it's got nothing to do with security. It's a law. And law is for lawyers, and the legal guys or the head of legal in your company is going to deal with it. I think nothing can be more farther than the truth. The reality is that if you are a CSO, or if you are concerned with the security operations of your company or information or cyber security generally speaking, then you have to know about this legislation. Why? Because this is India's only mother legislation dealing with use of computers, electronic format, the digital ecosystem, and also mobiles. In fact, when you look at the legislation earlier, in 2000 when it was passed, it was a relatively very small focused legislation. It was focused primarily on use of computers, computer systems, and computer networks. However, from the time it actually started, and when it was started, the government was very clear. The Parliament wanted it to be a law for promoting e-commerce in the country. It also was primarily seen as a vehicle for promoting electronic governance in India, and it sought to amend four different laws of the country, being the Indian Penal Code, the Bankers Books Evidence Act, the Indian Evidence Act, and of course the Reserve Bank of India Act. However, from 2000 till 2008, a lot of water actually flew down the bridge. Consequently, we found that there was need for so much amendments into this legislation, because this legislation did not really address a large number of issues which already were emerging. That's the reason why the government amended this legislation in 2008 and has made it far more comprehensive. Now the question is, how comprehensive it is? The first thing is, this is India's only answer to the digital and mobile ecosystem. Anything digital, anything electronic, the electronic format, electronic form, is going to be covered by this legislation. It's not just use of computers. It's all kinds of devices which have data processing capabilities, which have memory functions, are now covered under this. And now, thanks to the 2008 amendments, all kinds of communication devices, be it normal phones or smartphones, personal digital assistants, iPads, Blackberries, you name it and you have it, all these devices are now covered under the legislation. Now, from a CSO's perspective, you need to have certain important things ready. The first thing is that this law has legalized electronic format. Anything legal, and that becomes anything which is electronic, is now legal in the country, can be